In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, peace be to you, dear friends. I am your brother Mario Joseph from Philokalia. Last few days, many prayer intention came to me, especially from Middle Eastern area. People say that they lost the job without any information. Morning, they went to their office, then immediately the termination letter in their hand. They don't know where to go and what to do. And many said that we were searching for job last 2-3 years and we could not find one and we are struggling searching for job. Brother Mario, the survival is very important. We don't know how to survive. You know, the house rent is different and car rent is different and children's education and daily food. We are struggling financially. We don't know what to do. And especially I'm recording this talk for the job hunters. When I received many prayer requests from jobless people saying that pray for us so that we may find a good job, I sat in prayer and I kept all their name in my prayer. Not only my prayer, I asked my team also to pray for them. And while we were praying, we received a few Bible verses for the people, those who are searching for job, those who are job hunters. And I know that whatever God says about you and about me, that will happen one day. Our duty is to believe in. And God inspired me to record this talk so that you may listen this word of God and you may believe that word of God, and that belief will become true in your life and you will be blessed with a good job. Of course, my brothers and sisters, all over the world, around the globe, people are suffering due to this COVID as well as some flood and some natural calamities. I know that everyone are suffering financially. But if you get this video in your hand, remember that God wants to bring a breakthrough in your life. He wants to bless you. That's the reason the video in your hand. Please listen carefully and repeat these prayers that will bless you. And why I say that these prayers will bless you, first reason, when I uploaded a video regarding tabernacle prayer, hundreds and thousands of testimonies that they have received the blessings according to their wish, all their good wishes were granted. And the second thing, I have uploaded a video regarding about the prayer to Our Lady, the undoer of knots. And many people testified that they received the breakthrough in their life. That's why I say these words is also going to bring a big breakthrough in your life. Please memorize and recite this prayer. Please listen to me, my brothers and sisters. If you are a job hunter and if you are searching for a new job, or if you are waiting to get a promotion in your job, or if you are searching to begin your own business, or if you are searching to go somewhere abroad, or if you are preparing yourself to write an exam, so that you will get a job, remember to memorize these three verses from Bible. The first one, you all know, that is from Jeremiah chapter 29 verses 11. Jeremiah 29, 11. Verses says like this: "For I know the plan that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for calamity, to give you future and a hope." Please memorize this word, Isaiah 29, 11. Before you go to an interview or before you go to search for a job, memorize this word and recite this word. After reciting this word, you just say a prayer. "Lord, I believe in your promise. It is you who promised me that you have a plan about me for my welfare, not for destruction. Now I got this job and I am in search and I am going to get this promotion. I am going to do this business. Let it be your will and let it be the welfare for me and the people, those who depend on me, my family members." After this prayer, you go and do that. The second word, what I want to tell you before you appear for an interview or before you begin a business or, you know, when you are preparing for an exam, please memorize Philippians 4:19. It says, "And my God will supply every need of yours according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus." Please memorize this word. After memorizing, recite this word once. And second trip, you must recite this word the way I'm going to recite it now. Please listen. "And my God will supply every need of mine." Pause there and say, narrate your need. "I need this job. I need this business. I need this much money. I need this property." Whatever your need should be added there. After adding, you have to read that word once again. Let me read it for you. "And my God will supply every need of mine." This job or this business or whatever it may be, "according to his riches in glory in Christ Jesus." So what you're doing, God already promised you that he will fulfill all your need according to his riches. And you're adding your need there and you're claiming, saying that what you promised is mine. You know, my brothers and sisters, whatever you believe from the Bible and whatever you claim from the Bible, that is yours. Now, my brothers and sisters, please remember to subscribe my YouTube channel, Philokalia Official in English. And there is a video, The Power of Subconscious Mind and the Power of Prayer. And if you listen that video properly, then you will know the power of this word, what you're going to memorize. Because whatever you memorize from the word of God, especially the promises what God gives to you, that you are planting in your subconscious mind. And if you plant that word in the subconscious mind, remember that word is a seed and that will grow and that will produce the fruit for you. So remember this Philippians 4:19 throughout your life, that is going to bring a big breakthrough in your life. And the third word, what I want you to memorize is that when you are sitting in an interview, you know, when you are sitting in the auditorium for interview, or when you are sitting in a classroom for the exam, or when you are approaching an office, or when you are meeting people for a new business, remember to recite this word. That is from Isaiah 66 verses 12. Isaiah 66 verses 12 says, "For thus says the Lord, behold, I will extend prosperity to her like a river." Wow, such a beautiful promise. The Almighty God says the prosperity will be to you like a river, which means it will flow to you. Again it says, and the wealth of the nations like an overflowing stream. So the Indian nation will have enough wealth. I mean, the nation for you and for me is our family and our dear and near one. So we all will have enough wealth in prosperity. I didn't say, the Almighty God says. So memorize this word, and when you are meeting people for the business, or when you are meeting your elders for the promotion, or when you are sitting for an interview, just recite that word in your mind and that becomes true. You know, God will bring breakthrough immediately in your life, because it's not your promise. It's not my promise. It is the promise of Almighty God. Now let me pray for you, my brothers and sisters. Almighty God, the Father of this entire universe, the Creator of this entire universe, the Protector of this entire universe, the Deliverer of this entire universe, I surrender the one who is listening to me right now. I don't know from where he or she is listening to me, but if they are job hunters, if they are searching for a job, if they are in financial difficulty, if they are going to begin a new business, please stretch your right hand upon them and bless them according to these three verses, so that they may be able to give witness for you. In Jesus' name, amen. But at the same time, there will be a question from you, my brothers and sisters. Some of you may ask, brother, I have appeared many exams, but I was not successful. And I have appeared into many companies for interview, but I could not get. And sometime I get, but very soon I will lose the job. So somewhere some bondage and some blockages in me, I don't know what to do. I want you to memorize a word from Bible, that is from Romans chapter 8 verses 28. Romans 8, 28. The word of God says, and we know that God causes all things to work together for good to those who love God, to those who called according to his purpose. So my brothers and sisters, here the Bible says, if you're called by God, I know that you are called by God and I am called by God. You know why? That's why we are Christians. You receive a call means you receive a call to be baptized and to be the adopted child of God. So if you are already a baptized person, you are already called. And the second thing, if you love Jesus, that is a condition. So my brothers and sisters, if you decide to love Jesus with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul, he says that everything will be for your own good. So if you lost the job, that will be for your own goodness. And if you did not pass in the exam, that is for your own goodness. And if you did not get visa, then that is for your own goodness. And if you lost this business, that is for your own goodness. I didn't say, it is Bible says. So sometime even after leading a holy life, even after knowing that I am the child of God and I have been called by God and I love God and I am trying to be holy maximum, and I'm trying to earn money to support my family and I have some hurdles. Remember, God doesn't want you to do that business. God doesn't want you to do that job. He prepared already better one for you. That's why. So never lose the heart. Keep trying. Please remember to memorize one more word from Bible. That is Philippians chapter 4 verses 6 and 7. Philippians chapter 4 verses 6 and 7. Bible says, do not be anxious about anything. Hello, my brothers and sisters. You lost the job. Don't be anxious. You lost the business. Don't be anxious. You know, you lost the examination. Don't be anxious. I didn't say Bible says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all the understanding, will guard your hearts and your mind in Jesus Christ. I think this is what we all need. Many times, you know, we are restless and we are anxious and we are worried and we are not okay. We are not normal, I mean. And in that condition, if you're searching for a job, you're not going to win. Remember, my brothers and sisters, if your mind is not at ease, whatever you think is not normal, whatever you say is not normal, whatever you act is not normal. So bringing your mind at ease, in peace, is very important when you are a job hunter, when you are searching for a business or whatever it may be, my brothers and sisters. And how can you keep your mind at ease and peace? Very simple. Bible says, do not be anxious about anything. Surrender everything in prayer with thanksgiving. So thank the Lord for already what you have. If you have health, thank the Lord. If you have wife, thank the Lord. If you have children, thank the Lord. If you have at least one time meal, thank the Lord. Whatever you have, you say thanks to the Lord for that. And then surrender your request. Definitely there will be peace in your mind. I didn't say it's a promise of the Lord. So memorize this word and recite this word very often. That's how you can bring a peace in your mind and you can think normally and you can think very deeply and you can think, you can act very well and you can be successful in your life. And before ending this section, if you are tired of hunting job, if you are tired of searching some business, if you are tired of doing many things, please memorize this word from Almighty God, that is Isaiah chapter 40, verses 28 to 31. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, it does not become weary or tired. His understanding is inscrutable. He gives strength to the weary, and to him who lacks might, he increases power. Though youth grows weary and tired, and vigorous young men stumble badly, yet those who wait for the Lord will gain new strength. They will mount up with wings like eagles. They will run and not get tired. They will walk and not become weary. I did not say Almighty God says. God says, I am Almighty. I will never become tired. And again he said, all those who trust in me and all those who believe in me, they will never become tired. Youth may become tired and vigorous may become tired, but all those who trust me and all those who believe me, they will be like eagle. They will renew their health and they will fly again high. So my brothers and sisters, I don't know from where you are listening to me. I want to say one thing. If you are called by God and if you love God, be like eagle. God is going to bring a big breakthrough in your life and he is going to bless you in abundance. In 2021, you will say that many were struggling, but God blessed me in abundance through these Bible verses. As I said in the beginning of this class, let me tell you once again, please subscribe my YouTube channel, Philo Calio Official in English. And remember to recite the tabernacle prayer and the prayer to Our Lady, Undoer of Knots. And then memorize these verses. This is going to bring a big miracle in your life. May Almighty God bless you and peace be with you.